हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई वेलकम यू इन लेक्चर नंबर 21 ऑन डबल इंटीग्रल्स। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद दिस प्रॉब्लम। चेंज द ऑर्डर ऑफ इंटीग्रेशन एंड इवेल्युएट दिस डबल इंटीग्रल, वेयर ऑर्डर ऑफ इंटीग्रेशन इज फर्स्ट विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू वाई एंड देन विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू एक्स। सो दीज आर द लिमिट्स ऑफ वेरिएबल वाई एंड दीज आर द लिमिट्स ऑफ वेरिएबल एक्स। So we have to change the order of integration and then we have to find out the value of integral. So given order is dy dx. So we have to first change the order of integration such that it becomes dx dy. For this order we use vertical line. So we have to consider horizontal line in this problem to find out value of double integral. So first we will sketch the region of integration using given limits and then we will consider horizontal line passing through the region to determine the new limits of x and y, and using those new limits we will integrate in this order to evaluate this double integral. So first we have written that in given integral the order of integration is first with respect to y and then with respect to x, and for this order we use vertical line. And then we have written the limits of integration which are given in given integral. So y is from x to y equal to square root of 2 minus x square, and x is from 0 to x equal to 1. So we are writing these limits. So using these limits we will be able to sketch the region of integration. So if we consider this curve y equal to square root of 2 minus x square, and if we take square on both sides we have y square equal to 2 minus x square, and if we take this x square on left hand side we have x square plus y square equal to 2, and this 2 we can rewrite as square of under root 2. So this is the circle with center origin and radius square root of 2. Now we have to decide the intersecting points of all these curves. We have these three lines and this circle. So we will determine the intersecting points. So first we will determine the intersecting points of these three lines x equal to 0, x equal to 1, y equal to x with this circle. So first we put x equal to 0 in the equation of circle. So we can see if we put x equal to 0 we will obtain y square equal to 2, that means y equal to plus or minus 2, that we have written here. Putting x equal to 0 in x square plus y square equal to 2 we obtain y square equal to 2. So possible values of y are plus or minus square root of 2. So x equal to 0 intersects circle x square plus y square equal to 2 at two points 0 comma root 2 and 0 comma minus root 2. Similarly we can put x equal to 1 here and we see what we obtain. So for x equal to 1 this equation becomes 1 plus y square equal to 2, that is y square is 1, that means y is plus or minus 1. So for x equal to 1 these are the intersecting points with circle. X is 1 and y is 1 and minus 1, so 1 1 and 1 minus 1. And finally we put y equal to x in the equation of circle and see what we obtain. So putting y equal to x in x square plus y square equal to 2, we obtain x square plus x square equal to 2, that is 2x square equal to 2, 2 will cancel out, so we obtain x square equal to 1, so x is plus or minus 1, and x and y are equal, so when x is 1, y is 1, when x is minus 1, y is minus 1. So these two will intersect, circle and line y equal to x will intersect at these points. So once we have intersecting points, we can easily sketch the region of integration. So first we sketch this circle and then we will sketch remaining lines. So these are the coordinate axes. X axis means y equal to 0. This is y axis means x equal to 0. So here I have to sketch the circle. So first I sketch this circle and then I will consider appropriate scale so that I have a rough sketch of circle. It will look like circle. We just require rough sketch of the circle. It should look like circle. You don't have to sketch the perfect circle. So this is the circle with center 0, 0 and radius root 2. So this point must be root 2 comma 0 and this point must be minus root 2 comma 0. And our lines are x equal to 0, x equal to 1 and y equal to x. So y equal to x means line passing through origin making angle 45 degree. So this is the line y equal to x and we have seen that y equal to x intersects circle at point 1, 1 and minus 1, minus 1. So and x equal to 1 also intersects circle at point 1, 1. So this is the line x equal to 1. Vertical line passing through these points is x equal to 1. It intersects the circle at point 1, 1 and 1 comma minus 1. So this point is nothing but 1 comma 0. So let me check whether we have done all these things. X is from 0 to 1 and y is from x to y equal to under root 2 minus x square. X equal to 0, that is y axis intersects 0 plus or minus root 2. So this is y axis, it intersects the circle at 0 root 2 and this point is 0 minus root 2. Then x equal to 1 intersects 1 1 and 1 minus 1, that we have already noted. Y equal to x intersects 1, 1 and minus 1, minus 1. That is also noted. So now, x is in between 0 and 1. Limits of integration are, x starts from 0 and up to x equal to 1. And y is starting from x and going up to circle. So now we have to determine the region which satisfies these limits. So first we consider x is from 0 to x equal to 1. So leftmost part is this y axis, that is x equal to 0 and x equal to 1 is here. Y is starting from x. So this is the lower boundary, y equal to x. And we have to go up to circle. Upper limit for y is square root of 2 minus x square. And we have to mention that equation of circle is x square plus y square equal to 2. So y is from x to circle and x is from 0 to 1. So this is the region of integration. Now in given integral, order of integration is with respect to y first and then with respect to x. That order is obtained by using vertical line. And to change the order of integration, we have to consider horizontal line passing through region of integration. So our region looks like this. So now if we consider horizontal line, this point is 1, 1. So if we consider horizontal line in this part, it will leave the region on the line y equal to x. And if we consider horizontal line in this part, it will leave the region on the circle. It will enter the region on the same curve, that is on y-axis. But if we consider horizontal line below this line is y equal to 1. So if we consider horizontal line below this line y equal to 1, then line will enter on y-axis, but it will leave on y equal to x. And if we consider horizontal line in this region, line will leave on the circle. So this indicates that we have to divide the region of integration into two sub-regions. So we make partition from this point. We consider this horizontal line, which is nothing but line y equal to 1. So this point is 0, 1. And we have to make the partition. So we indicate them by different colors. Suppose this is region R1. And suppose this region is region R2. So our region of integration is divided into two sub-regions, R1 and R2. So we have to consider horizontal lines passing through both the regions. So I consider one horizontal line passing through this region, and I consider another horizontal line passing through region R2. Now in region R1, let me mention that this is region R1 and this is region R2. Now both the lines enters on the same curve, that is y-axis, and on y-axis value of x is 0. So here both the lines enter at x equal to 0. So lower limit of x in both the region is x equal to 0. Now if we consider line in the region R1, then it leaves on the line y equal to x. So here we consider upper limit of x is x equal to y. And this point is on the circle. It leaves the region on the circle. So we have to find out value of x from the equation of circle. So here we can see x square is 2 minus y square. And if we consider square root, we have x equal to plus or minus square root of 2 minus y square. But on this side, to the right side of y axis, x is positive. So we ignore negative sign, x is square root of 2 minus y square. Now in region R1, lowermost point is origin. So limit of y in R1, lower limit for y in R1 is 0. R1 will start from this point. So at this point, value of y is 0. And we have to go up to this line. So these are the uppermost points of the region R1. At all these points, value of y is 1. So we are going up to this point, and all these points are on the line y equal to 1. So y is from 0 to 1 for region R1. For region R2, all these are lowermost points. So y has lower limit 1 in the region R2. And we have to go up to this point. So this is the uppermost point of region R2, this point. And at this point, value of y is root 2. So y is from 1 to root 2 in the region R2. So now once we have limits of integration, we can find out the value of double integral using these new limits. Before that, we have to just mention that to change the order of integration, we consider horizontal lines passing through regions or sub-regions R1 and R2 as shown in figure. And then we mention the new limits of integration. So the new limits of integration are, so first we mention for region R1, in R1 x is from 0 to x equal to y and y is from 0 to 1. So in R1 x is from 0 to x equal to y and y is from 0 to y equal to 1. And then we write for R2, in R2 lower limit for x is same and upper limit is square root of 2 minus y square and y starts from 1 and up to square root of 2. So in R2 x is 0 as lower limit and upper limit is x equal to square root of 2 minus y square and limits of y are from 1 to square root of 2. So therefore order of integration is now first with respect to x and then with respect to y. Therefore order of integration is first with respect to x and then with respect to y. So now we write down equivalent integral which is obtained by changing the order of integration. Before that we write down the given integral x over square root of x square plus y square x divided by square root of x square plus y square dy dx, y is from x to square root of 2 minus x square and x is from 0 to 1, y is from x to square root of 2 minus x square, x is from 0 to 1. So this was the given double integral and after changing the order of integral we obtain x over square root of x square plus y square. Here order is changed now dx dy and double integral over R1 plus double integral over R2 x divided by square root of x square plus y square dx dy. So now we write down the limits and before that we rewrite this integral as x times x square plus y square raised to minus 1 by 2. This we can rewrite in this way dx dy. In R1 x is from 0 to y and y is from 0 to 1 plus, here also we rewrite in this way, x times x square plus y square raised to minus 1 by 2 dx dy, x is from 0 to square root of 2 minus y square and y is from 1 to square root of 2. So now first we have to integrate with respect to x. So for that we consider this inner integral. We evaluate this inner integral first So this is just for conveniency. It is not compulsory to write in the bracket. Here integration is with respect to x, so we will consider y as constant. Same thing here, while integrating with respect to x, we consider y as constant. So here y is constant, therefore y square is constant. And if we take derivative of x square plus y square with respect to x, we have 2x. So we can set the derivative of x square plus y square in the product. Here we have x and we require 2x. So we can multiply with 2 and divide with 2. So we rewrite x as 1 by 2 times 2x. And 1 by 2 is constant, so we write it outside the integral. Same thing here, 1 by 2 and 2x. So we can use that formula, that we are able to use this formula. Nth power of fx into derivative of fx equal to fx raised to n plus 1 over n plus 1, if n is different from minus 1. Here n is different from minus 1, n is minus 1 by 2. So first we find out value of this integral is now x square plus y square raised to minus 1 by 2 plus 1, that is 1 by 2 divided by 1 by 2. So now we write down 1 by 2. This remains as it is. Y is from 0 to 1. Integral becomes x square plus y square raised to minus 1 by 2 plus 1, that is 1 by 2 divided by 1 by 2. Limits of x are from 0 to y, and integral with respect to y. Same thing here, 1 by 2 instead of y equal to 0 to 1. Here we have y is from 1 to square root of 2. Integral is same, x square plus y square raised to 1 by 2 divided by 1 by 2. And limits of x are from 0 to square root of 2 minus y square, and then we integrate with respect to y. Okay, fine. So now we have used this formula that we have mentioned in the bracket. Now we can see this 1 by 2 will cancel out, and then we put the limits. First we put x equal to y here. So we have y square plus y square, that is 2y square raised to 1 by 2. And minus x equal to 0, that is y square raised to 1 by 2. So first we write down the limits. Y is from 0 to 1. Upper limit is x equal to y. So y square plus y square, that is 2y square raised to 1 by 2. Okay, let me write one more step. 2y square raised to 1 by 2 minus x equal to 0, that is y square raised to 1 by 2. Okay, then we will simplify. First we write down as it is dy. Okay, let me check again. X is y, so x equal to y, that is y square plus y square, which is 2y square raised to 1 by 2, minus x is 0, that is 0 plus y square raised to 1 by 2, which is y square raised to 1 by 2. Now, we consider this second integral. Y is from 1 to square root of 2. First, we have to put x equal to square root of 2 minus y square. So x square is 2 minus y square, and plus y square raised to 1 by 2. So for upper limit, 2 minus y square plus y square raised to 1 by 2, and lower limit is x equal to 0. So we obtain same thing here also, y square raised to 1 by 2 and then integral with respect to y. So again we repeat, here we have x equal to square root of 2 minus y square. So if we take square, we have 2 minus y square and plus y square raised to 1 by 2. That is for upper limit. Minus, for x equal to 0, we have y square raised to 1 by 2. Okay, so next step is, we simplify this integral from 0 to 1. 2 raised to 1 by 2, that is square root of 2, y square raised to 1 by 2, which is y. Here also we obtain y, y square raised to 1 by 2, that is y. Plus integral from 1 to root 2. Here 2 raised to 1 by 2, that is square root of 2 minus y square raised to 1 by 2, which is y. So now this is simple integral, and here we can take y common from these two, and we have square root of 2 minus 1 y dy, and here we can integrate root 2 y minus y square by 2. Y has limits 1 to root 2. And here also we integrate root 2 minus 1 is constant, and integral of y is y square by 2. Limits are from 0 to 1. Here if we could consider upper limit, we have root 2 into root 2, that is 2. So for upper limit, we have root 2 into root 2, that is 2, minus root 2 square, that is 2 divided by 2, which I directly write as 1, minus y equal to 1, that is root 2, minus 1 by 2. And here also, for y equal to 1, we have 1 by 2, and minus y equal to 0. So 1 by 2 minus 0, that is 1 by 2. This is 1 minus root 2 plus 1 by 2. Now we multiply root 2 minus 1 with 1 by 2. So root 2 divided by 2, that is 1 by root 2 minus 1 by 2. This 1 plus 1 by 2 is 3 by 2 and minus root 2. So this is going to be 3 minus 1, that is 1, 2 by 2, that is 1. 3 minus 1, that is 2 divided by 2, which is 1, and minus root 2. So this we can simplify if we wish. We can take LCM as square root of 2. So this is going to be 1 plus root 2. We multiply this by root 2. So we obtain here root 2 into root 2, that is 2. And we have root 2 minus 1 divided by root 2, which we can rewrite as 1 minus 1 by root 2. So this is the value of double integral after changing the order of integration. So this is very nice example. Here we are asked to change the order of integration, therefore we have to divide our region into two sub-regions. If we were not asked to change the order of integration, then it was simple. We could have considered vertical line, and we did not have to divide the region into two sub-regions. But here our question is that we have to evaluate the integral after changing the order of integration, so we cannot go in this order. We strictly have to consider horizontal line. So here we have to divide the region into two sub-regions to integrate with respect to x first and then with respect to y. So this is all about today's session. I hope you like this lecture. Thank you very much.